Their culture and connection to country has endured despite colonisation, and they have fought a long battle to win native title rights. So I want to pay tribute to their exceptional leaders, past, present and emerging, who have instigated and engaged us for this project. As a community, they have driven the brave, had input into the designs, been involved through construction, and now manage and operate the facilities. Gunditjmara country is located in southwest Victoria and follows the path of the lava flow from Budj Bim down to the coast. It's a rich and fertile place, covered with remnants of settlements, permanent villages of stone huts, and elaborate aquaculture systems. The Budj Bim Cultural Landscape has been recognised by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. Our work on this project centres on storytelling, where the architecture acts as a vehicle for the sharing of culture. In pragmatic terms, the development provides an environmentally, socially and economically sustainable means of caring for and remaining connected to country. It creates meaningful employment opportunities for many members of the community through the provision of infrastructure to support a tourism business. The facilities we've designed are many and varied, from a crater rim lookout to a visitor centre, boardwalks, toilets, information shelters, picnic shelters, a bird hide, a bridge, a jetty, an aquaculture centre and a café. The project spans five separate sites that have been physically fragmented by colonisation, but they are, of course, all one cultural landscape. The need to convey this continuity really informed our design approach, and there are a number of consistent themes that carry across all the sites. Firstly, the architecture acts as an interpretive device, helping to make country legible to non-Indigenous eyes. Views of important cultural features are framed in each location as the architecture leads the visitor through a curated experience of the landscape. At Budj Bim, the axial lookout frames a view of the summit or high head of the creator beam, and at the opposite end, it directs views down the lava flow. At Tayrak, the axis of the jetty is also aligned with the Budj Bim summit, making a direct visual link between these sites. While at Curtinage, viewing platforms frame the ancient remnants of stone fish traps. The act of screening is equally important as framing. At the Tyrendarra Rec Reserve, a veil of charred timber battens is used to screen the post-colonial landscape of an adjacent sports ground and farmland, while opening up to views of Kalara, the creek that was a source of food and water, enabling the visitor to focus on the Budj Bim story. With ancient stone artefacts scattered across many sites, the ground plane is treated with great care. An extensive CHMP process informed the alignment of boardwalks, where they carefully skirt around ancient fishing and stone house sites. The set out of every single footing was considered, and they sit above ground in most cases to minimise disturbance. The paths of boardwalks were realigned multiple times during the design phase and also construction as new features were uncovered, and the builders were instructed not to move a single rock without permission. The sites were challenging to build on in other ways too. Most are off-grid, they were difficult to access, subject to seasonal flooding, as well as the threat of bushfire, and the designs had to accommodate all of these risks. To deal with this, we developed a design that was an adaptable system, with many variations. They were mostly prefabricated as a kit of parts, and then carried in by hand and assembled on site. Elements such as curb rails, seats, interpretive panels, balustrades or walls were employed at different locations, allowing the boardwalks to adapt to the varied terrain and serve multiple functions. The Budj Bim landscape is subtle and cultural features are not always obvious, so the designs are intended to slow the visitor down. Paths and boardwalks take sinuous routes. They are punctuated with moments that encourage visitors to make careful observation, engage with place, and generate curiosity with the placement of elements such as a bird hide, a viewing platform or a group fire pit. The restrained material palette is designed to recede, allowing the natural and cultural landscape to come to the fore. Weathered steel, charred timber cladding, red gum, local volcanic stone, loose stone and black painted steel are used in different combinations at each site. The palette is also intended to be immediately recognisable, with the repetition of consistent materials and language reinforcing the message that the cultural landscape is continuous. The notion of identity is considered in both a local and a broader context, At the Aquaculture Centre, the charred timber cladding references the traditional use of fire in the smoking of kuyang or eel and cultural burning. The saffete and external walls under the veranda are lined with red gum, a common species found on Gunditjmara country, while ribbons of gold-painted steelwork complete the tripartite colour scheme of black, red and gold. Geometry is deliberately kept elemental, with silhouette-like forms creating an experience of enclosure that still leaves room for the visitor to imagine traditional forms of dwelling. Variations of arcs, circles and arches are used as recurring motifs in many locations. On the public viewing deck at the Aquaculture Centre, a large circular tank holds kuyang, an important traditional food source. The doors off this deck lead into the back of house area, where facilities for smoking and packaging kuyang will provide a future income stream. Stepping inside the tasting room, there is a layering of further cultural references. The interior is lined with plywood panelling routed with patterns from the Tayrak possum skin cloak. The richly textured lining prompts a conversation about the significance of the patterns and the connection to country that they represent. The serving bench is made from a single slab of red gum, shaped in the form of a traditional shield, and full-scale footprints of stone huts are inlaid within the flooring. Finally, I would like to touch on process, because this project has been unlike any other that we have worked on. It's involved a huge amount of consultation to learn and capture input from a broad cross-section of the community. And we've spent hundreds of hours on country. The importance of making enough time for meaningful engagement really can't be overstated, and we believe being based in the region ourselves made a real difference. In the words of Damien Bell, former CEO of Budj Bim Cultural Landscape and a key visionary behind the project, the walkways, lookouts and Tayrak Café provide places for our elders, community and visitors to sit and share yarns and a feed. The designs through the Budj Bim